good morning. We've had two losses now, and trying to find those complete games and as a team. And there's been times throughout the season where we've played very complimentary, maybe takeaways and scoring. It might be one team needs a little pick me up, the other comes through. But when the losses happen, those things get amplified. Where you certainly really look into that more. We got to play better as a team. That's what great teams do. So we haven't been our best in those two games in particular. I know there's other times we can always look and we got to improve, but can't have the mistakes, can't have the penalties, got to have better execution. All those things that put you behind the eight ball throughout the course of the game. Here in the SEC, there's such a fine line, obviously, between winning and losing. And that's how you get beat. And so, that's on all of us. It starts with me, just continue to set the standard that will lead to high performance. And I know that it just comes down to competing, being solution oriented every day, bringing everything you have to the football team. I'm confident in a group of guys that want to be great. There's no doubt about it. I can see it in their response each and every day. Just showing up to work, and so I have no doubt that that's going to continue to happen. We know that just being a championship football team is hard. We all signed up for it. We all want to continue to improve our awareness, our intensity, and that's not just intensity on the football field and all that. That's just everything we do. We know it takes everything we got, and that's what we signed up for. So. I think the biggest thing is the message has been over the weeks, not just this week or not just after Vanderbilt, but the weeks, all season long, the message is always going to be there's never going to be excuses. That's the one thing that, only softens character, it lowers the standard, and that will never happen. And so, again, talk about being solution-oriented, continue about moving forward, making sure you got the right people here, and firmly believe that we have a lot of great people with a lot of great skill sets, whether it's players, staff, and that they're all working together. And so really, know that that's gonna be the case. Kind of moving on to a couple other things, just with injuries, give you an update. I know with Keon Sapp, he does have a lower extremity injury. We're still gathering information here, but we do expect him to be down for a while. That could be an extended amount of time, and we'll just continue to evaluate that. There's a lot of, I think, one position group in particular, just kind of put them all together. All the other DBs, I think, just look to see how they progress throughout the week. A lot of similarities between just kind of the level of the injuries that they all have. Right now, I'd be expecting them all to be able to play Saturday, so we'll be ready to go. When it comes to Missouri, just Coach Drinkwitz, especially over the last 2 years, but I know it takes time for him to build to this, has done a great job. Great football coach, just as far as how he's developing guys and bringing the right people into his program. Got some transfers that have added to a solid group of returning starters, 17-3 over the last 2 years. Just a resilient group on some close games. And so we got another great task at hand, as they're all going to always be in the SEC. And our guys are looking forward to the challenge. This week's going to be where we get back to work and bring a homecoming win back home for all our fans.
Thank you, Coach. We'll start with Charlie Potter here on the right.
Yeah, Coach, just with Jalen, is he dealing with anything from an injury standpoint, maybe banged up a little bit? And if not, what do you do to kind of build his confidence up after the last 2 weeks?
Sure. Yeah, I think at this point of the year, I don't think there's many guys that play a lot of snaps who don't have something, and just working through it. But he's more than capable, and, as he goes through the week, just ready to play on Saturday. So there's nothing that's going to be holding him back from me going out there and being able to help us get a win. Confident of that.
Stay on the right side, Kirk. Kirk, right there.
coach, I know the head coach is responsible for everything, but I wonder if there, some coaches take exclusive responsibility for things like play calling, for instance, or substitutions or clock management. I wonder what sort of things you are, besides your veto power, anything that are exclusive to you.
Yeah, I think all those things you mentioned are part of the job responsibility and how I look at it, and you know, take all those things seriously. And so every element of the program, it's always you know, things that I'm going to discuss if it involves other people, which usually it does, and go to those people. You know, making sure our coaching staff is always aligned on the same page, whether it is the play calling, whether it is the situational piece, off the field, recruiting efforts, making sure everything's always aligned. And so, you know, evaluating, you know, I'll tell you this, a lot of times there's situations that do come up that really work out for you. And, you know, you think about many times where, you know, in the past with different teams and all of that, you know, maybe it's not the decision you would have made as far as that particular call, but there's a lot of good calls that you can make that all work. And so is what happens is you got to make sure that the guys are prepared, they're confident, and they go out and execute what it is that that you've been working on. So, you know, I have full confidence in who we have, and my job is to continue to guide them, give them, you know, my perspective, be there in the moment in the games, to continue to make sure we're sticking to the plan that we, you know, that we worked on, that was created, the ones that the guys have practiced, and just making sure we're staying the course, you know, in that moment, then also staying the course as we continue to develop our players over the course of the year, years, and their careers.
Coach Chase, far left.
I wanted to ask you about the personal foul against Kendrick Law at the end of the game to set up the 4th-22. What was your, I don't think you got asked about that on Saturday, what was your message to him after the game on that?
Yeah, I mean, well, the message continues to be right with the team. It's not just one. It's you know, we gotta learn from those moments. Those moments are big, and you know, our choices, our decisions, our words, our actions. I mean, all of those things. You know, they have to be focused on what's best for our team. And obviously, in that moment, you know, we're fighting to try to find a way to win, and it's a big moment. So. You know, we got to make sure we, of course, address them, but we got to, you know, we can't have continue to have the mistakes, and that those are particular that we can control. Some things you just can't control, the things that happen to you, the way the ball bounces, and all of those things. So, you know, I think just everything in general, it starts with our thoughts. We got to make sure other people's thoughts don't become ours, and we got to make sure that, you know, if someone's talking to us, we got to learn to walk the other way. Being more emotionally disciplined in every facet, not just the high aggression type things, but also just when, you know, the momentum swings and things like that happen in the game, be able to trust in your preparation, trust in what you're doing. But yeah, we gotta be better. We gotta be better there. See, that's an important part of what great teams do. It's be great in those times.
Second row left, Tony.
Obviously, if Keon's going to be out for any time, you're going to need Bray Hubbard to step up. Just what have you seen from him, and how much has he grown in this season?
Yeah, you know, Bray's been working hard for this opportunity, and you know, he worked not just last week, but every week he's worked to be ready, and we had no doubt that he would be come Saturday when he was called upon, and he'll go out there again this week, and you know, our team really believes in him. He does a lot of things on special teams, and you can see it every day in practice. And so he's been around the program, and now, you know, this is that time, that next up, you know, next man up mentality. You know, that's what we talk about, and that's what it's got to be. And I know, again, high level of want to that he has, and, you know, excited for his opportunity. You know, I love Keon to death, and Keon's he's a warrior, man. There's more things I want to say about Keon and what he did to go out there and try to help our football team. But there's a, you know, next man up mentality, and I'm excited for, you know, the opportunity that Bray has in front of him.
jump right across the aisle here to Matt.
What needs to happen offensively to better capitalize on some of those defensive takeaways?
Yeah, you know, it's different, I think, each week, right? We talk about matchups and how they present themselves. But a lot of the things were just, drive stalling because we were, I don't want to say it's always shooting yourself in the foot, but we weren't executing, or something we do, it would happen, and a lot of times it was, right? False starts or whatever it might be. We just wasted plays and got ourselves behind the chains. We weren't able to have our full offense available on every play. And, we were good at that early in the season. And we got to get back to, taking advantage of those opportunities, playing off the defense and those momentum swings, keeping them on our side when those times come. So credit to the defense now. A couple weeks in a row, they've got the ball loose or they've made some interceptions. And again, we got to play team football and make those opportunities really pay off.
I wrote that third row there.
Just to clarify on the injuries in secondary, does that include Xavier? Because I know we didn't see him for most of the game there.
Yeah, that'd be Xavier, Devontae, Jalen Rosser, Red, in that group as well.
Left side, Colin.
Hey, I'm curious, do you feel like there's off a learning curve in terms of Jalen Rosser and the rest of the offense, in terms of learning your offensive scheme, adapting to what you expect?
Yeah, I'm just really, I'm pleased with a lot of the things that he's done and the way he's really wanted to learn the offense, our system. I think there's always a management of the game that goes between coaching staff and your quarterback, because he's the ultimate guy on the field that runs the show. I think we asked, is there a learning curve? I think there always is. I think it continues, but obviously we're halfway through the season, and we got to make sure we continue to do things he's comfortable with, which I think he's comfortable with. Everything we ask him. There's also then situations you get into that are in front of you. How many times do you like to be in second longs, third longs? Those are hard on any quarterback, no matter how good you are. So. I know in Jalen's case, I know how he takes it all on himself, but there's other things that we all can do to help support him and keep him from being in those tough spots, especially when you have a loud environment, and it's hard enough just to be able to communicate with your team, make those extra little checks or calls that need to be made. That energy is a lot. We need to come through and help him a lot with it more too. And, Just like you guess, he can continue to improve well as well.
A couple more questions. Start with Katie, second row there.
It's obviously been a small sample size overall with his number of attempts here at Alabama, but in his career, Graham's 1-for-4 on kicks of 50 yards or more. And we've seen Connor handle the kickoffs this year. Has there been any consideration of Connor maybe doing longer kicks, or is Graham kind of the guy y'all are sticking with for all footballs?
Yeah, I have a lot of confidence in Connor. I've really seen Connor in practice, so I continue to really be more consistent than I remember in the spring. And I think we were right on the edge of what Grant was capable of. I felt that. Didn't think about, just which way the kicks, even though there was just a small wind, looking for that little, I knew it would be close. You go with your gut on those things. And obviously it came up just short, but I felt like he was on point. I felt like he could put a good solid swing on it. We got a lot of confidence in both of those guys, to be honest with you.
Let's finish up, Jonathan, all the way back.
Hey, Coach King was talking about in adverse times like this. He said you got to keep the main thing, focus on this Missouri game. As you get later in the season, things like standings, rankings, that kind of thing creeps in and maybe becomes a conversation. How do you do that, and how do you keep the guys focused on just what's ahead this week?
Yeah, I still feel like, really, my experiences have been there's too much football left, and maybe the last week you try to give some perspective, because there's so many things that can change between now and then. So that's really, as Kane, I guess, it said, but that's really, where our focus is at, is just this game 1-0. I already heard in the locker room from our players, they understand the big picture is one thing. In order to make the big picture relevant, we have to take care of what's in front of us, and we got to continue to, you know, build, do what championship teams do, build on championship caliber teams do, build on your belief, build on your, you know, just intensity and everything that that you do, and then just have some grit. You know, I think if you look across the championships that have been won in this program, obviously I wasn't a part of them, but there's probably a lot of common things that I just mentioned that are you know, right there. I firmly believe that this team is capable of that. We just gotta jump over that line that is a fine line on, you know, the winning and losing and what it takes to be great. And we have the people here that are gonna work hard to do everything they can within their means to make that happen. So I'm excited to get back to work. We knew this wasn't gonna be easy. We knew this was winning a championship each and every year, especially the SEC, is gonna be hard. We knew there were gonna be challenges along with transitions, all that. No excuses. You know, we gotta continue to move forward. We gotta continue to build. And you know, that's what this week is all about, is taking that next step.
Thank you, Coach.
One time.